I think that the draw to Howard County at one point and to Columbia was its diversity.
Erica Chavaria is a teacher at the Howard County school she attended in high school, Wild Lake High School. It's in Columbia, the heart of the late developer James Rouse's plan to create a diverse community from scratch, where people of all races and incomes would live in the same communities. Wild Lake was known for its diversity. In 1999, 57% of students there were white, 33% were black, 2% Hispanic. 14% of students qualified for free and reduced school meals. But much has changed over 20 years.
And I think that over time, because of housing developments and where the money has gone and where people are moving, it's created these pockets of wealth.
Today, the number of white students attending Wild Lake has dropped to 25%. Black students now make up 46% of the school population, 13% are Hispanic. And the number of students qualifying for free and reduced meals has nearly tripled to 40%.
And I think a lot of it has to do with housing and where there's affordable housing, where there's low-income housing, where there's government housing, and then where there's not. And so we have families that can only afford to live in certain places.
Howard County's steady growth mirrors patterns that have occurred nationwide. Affordable housing is concentrated in certain areas, the more densely populated Columbia and the Route 1 I-95 corridor. More affluent communities have developed in outer areas where homes can sell in the millions. River Hill, in the western part of Columbia, Delegate Terry Hill notes, has no affordable housing.
River Hill, which was our final village under the Rouse plan, never had affordable housing planned into it. That's not what any part of Columbia should be. It's anathema to what Columbia is supposed to be about.
At River Hill High School in that area, the number of students who qualify for free and reduced meals is just 5.5%. In 1999, 7.8% of students were black. In 2019, the number of black students has barely budged, 10.8%.
The diversity that might have otherwise been there on socioeconomic grounds is absent because there were housing choices.
The Howard County School Superintendent wants to reassign some 7,400 students from their current schools to other schools in the county. His goals: reduce overcrowding and even out the number of lower income students across more schools.
The plan has generated intense debate. Some parents strongly oppose to reassignment of their children to other schools.
What concerns me about the debate is really my students. They hear what's happening. They hear the conversation that's being had. And unfortunately, a lot of what's being said is very hurtful towards a lot of my students.
It reflects that we have not come as far as we like to think we have. So these discussions are not very different from the discussions that we have every time there's significant redistricting.
The school board will decide the redistricting issue in 2 weeks. For the 11 News I-Team, I'm Jane Miller.